Good morning students, I am Vetri Chelvi from Vetri and Vetri Neat Chemistry. Today onwards I am going to give the video based on the NTA has given the set of some question for the appears for the practice, everybody knows of course. So from that mobile app the questions which is selectively I am selecting and under the different headings I am going to give. Today topic is here it is only collection of question regarding the physical chemistry. Okay, now let us see the first question. Ferrous oxide has a cubic structure and the AG length of the unit cell is 5 armstrong unit. Okay, next. The density is of the oxide is 4 gram per centimeter cube. Then the number of the ferrous ion and oxide ion present in the each unit cell will be. Point number 1. Let us see one by one. The name of the compound, let me write. Ferrous oxide formula is important. This is. And what they are asking in number of Fe plus and FeO2 mean they are asking is that this is the question. Now let us go and see the your formula. What is the formula for this is called density is equal to Z molar mass divided by that is Avogadro number into the what is called volume 8 to the power cube. It is the unit length. Here the what are the important things before going to substitute is here. The edge length A is given as what is it called 5 armstrong unit. What is 5 armstrong unit is? Armstrong unit means what is it called? This is convert into the 10 power minus 10 meter. Whereas here the density is given in the question is 4 gram per centimeter cube. So this should be in terms of the centimeter. So now what we are doing is meter to centimeter, that is meter to centimeter you have to multiply by 100. So now into 10 power 2, so now it's become 10 power minus 8 centimeter. What is this is call it as a unit length. First this work I am completing. Now let us go on do the substitution in this formula. Let me write here. Yes, D is equal to, it is given as the density. This is one thing is the density of the oxide is 4 gram per centimeter cube. Okay, now let me write this is density is equal to Z is the question and the molar mass. For molar mass, iron is 55.6 and the oxygen is 60. On adding, what you are getting is 1567. I am taking as a 72. Molar masses of the ferrous oxide is 72 divided by Avogadro number 6 into 10 power 23 into A is written here. It is, you can write as a A cube. 5 into 10 power minus 8 the whole cube. Next step 4 is equal to Z into 72 divided by 6 into 10 power 23 into 5 into 5 into 5 you are getting the 125 into 10 power minus 24. This is on cancelling 10 power plus 23. Here it is minus 24, so it's become minus 1. So now to remove this one, I am going to divide. Next step, I will come bring this one here. That is called Z into 72 divided by 6 into minus 1. I am bringing here it is 12.5. On getting cancelled this one. 12.5, let me take it as a 12. So this is on getting 6. 6 and 6 getting cancelled. So what we are getting is Z is equal to 4. So what is the answer is Z is equal to 4. That means what is number of atoms per unit cell is. Let us go and see. Your number of ion is 4 number and the oxygen is 4 number. Your option this is having 4 number of Fe2 plus and 4 number of oxide. So with like that you are finding the answer. This is the place only it is given as a new idea, new trick. Of course, suppose if you want to still do it tricky manner, I mean after finding out the idea you can go and verify wherever you are having the same number. Here 2 and 4 they are the not same number, so it is not the answer. 4 and 2 that is not the answer, whereas here 3 and 3 and here it is 4 and 4 both numbers are same together, so we are expecting the B and D may be the answer and after working out Z equal to 4 and we are coming to the conclusion of D. So now let us go into the next question. Determine the solubility of silver chromate at 298 Kelvin. It gives the solubility product value is given. Okay, now let me write the first your idea is you should write the formula for silver chromate, Ag ClO4 2 minus, now this is the formula which is ionized to give Ag plus plus ClO4 2 minus and stoichiometry balancing. Okay, for this what is the formula is, the solubility product for the formula is, K solubility product is equal to, tricky formula is x to the power x, y to the power s to the power of x plus y. This is the tricky in given in the NCERT book. Now what is the number of ion is silver is, how many numbers? 2. 2 to the power of 2 into the chromate ion is, how number is 1. So 1 to the power of 1 into, now I am bringing here, s to the power of, what is it, 2 plus 1. So now overall you are getting is 4 into s to the power of 3. This is the formula for this compound. Now let me write the values given for it. So now let me write, see the value is here. So now let me write the substitution. 4s cube is equal to 1.1 into 10 power minus 12. They are asking determine the solubility. So they are asking this is. Okay, now write the S cube is equal to 1.1 into 10 power minus 12 before bringing here. So what is the next thing is, here I am multiplied by 100. So this is become 110 divided by 4. 100 multiply mean divide, that one I am bringing here as a powers. Okay, now this is, okay, this is on cancelling. This one is on cancelling. Yes children, now this is, now what you are getting is 100, 420, 127.5. okay, next one is, here you bring it on the next, this one I am bringing the decimal here. So 275 into, multiply, so divide here, so it's become minus 15. So what is this is S cube. So S is equal to 275 into 10 power minus 15 to the power 1 by 3. So to remove the cubic root, you are putting here. Cube you are putting here. So next to your trick is, you can minus 15, you divide by 3, what we are getting is 10 to the minus 15 divided by 3, we are getting minus 5. So second part is minus 5. Go and see this part. This area we are getting one and only is the minus 5. A is the only thing. So you are automatically selecting the option A. You need not go for this, or you can verify with that this one of course. Okay children, now let us go to the, here again I am coming for the knowledges. Very simple. 1 minute children. Here what is it? You are having only 1 10 power minus 5. You are selecting this. Suppose you are having another 10 to the power minus 5 in. What we can do is this one with this. 6.5 should be the, you have to verify like 6 into 6 into 7. That is, you need not go for 6.5 into 6.5 into 6.5. Instead of that, for two things you reduce the minus for one thing. So this one if you are going mean 6 6 are 36, 36 into 7. Yes, you are getting 252. That is approximately you are getting. When you have to do this one, when you are having one more option with the 10 power minus 5, you can do verification with this in your backward. Okay, now I am giving the final shortcut for this. What is the thing is, even this equation in the exam hall you need not write. Of course, only with this you can straight away go to this. With this you can go and do this one. From that you can do it. These things you can avoid in the examination hall. We are going to the next one. The mole fraction of the solute in is 1 molar solution of this. This question so many times I insisted. It is very important. Of course, 2 times already came and this is again it is coming. Now let me write 1 mole of a solute. So 1 mole of a solute in is 1 molar aqueous solution. What is the meaning of 1 molar mean? They are writing mean it is 100 grams of water. That is, you can call it as a 1 liter or you can take it as a 100 grams of water as a solvent. Here children, one correction. What is it? 1 molar solute dissolves in its 1 molar aqueous solution. Since it is aqueous, I am taking as a water. And molar mean what is it? Given number of moles in the given solution should be in the weight. Here it is 1 kilogram, that should be, take it as a 1000 gram. So 1 mole of solid dissolve in the 1000 gram of the water. This is the knowledge of this sentence. So what they are asking is the mole fraction. What is a mole fraction? Mole fraction is equal to individual number of mole divided by the total number of moles. This is the formula. Individual number of mole, the solid is 1 divided by, here the total number of mole is 1 plus, here the for solvent, what is the thing is 1000 divided by 18. So now this is 1000 divided by 18 is 55.55. This is, even with the common knowledge you should know, that is called 1 liter of water 1000 gram is having the number of moles of water is 55.55. It is the known knowledge. So now what we have to write is 1 divided by 56.5. This one on simplification, this one. So now how I am going to do is into 100 here. Here also we are getting 100 means this is 56. That 56.5 into 100, this is what I have to do actually. So nearing approximation I am doing to it for the time sake factor. 56.5 we can take it as a 55 because it is easily cancelled by the 11 table. Okay, now what is happening is this is 5 and this is what you are getting is 20. This is this one 55 on cancelling with the 5, we are getting 11 and 100 by divide by 5 we are getting 20. So what we are have to do is 20 divided by 11 into 100. You divide the 20 by 11. See why I am taking is very simple. So 111, now what you are getting is 9. Here it is 0. So how much are 88. So what you are getting is 1.8 divided by 100. That is equal to 1. That is, we can go the 100 mean point, divide by 100 is become 0.018. So we are getting the exact answer is, option is 0.018 is the answer. So our option is A. So here the very important 1 mole fraction of the mole fraction of the solute they are asking. This is the formula. Mole fraction of solute is XV. So here simply I am correcting. Solute should be the B. Nothing else of course. In the 1 molar aqueous solution, here everything is given. Solute is 1 mole and this is the solvent. Here it is, we know it is a solute is here and here there is solute plus solvent. Representation only is just I am correcting. Remaining part is very simple. This is already 2 times they came. So we can expect the same question. Already I told. Now we are coming to the last equilibrium question is very simple only. 15 moles of hydrogen under the iodine are mixed and allowed to attain the equilibrium. So let me write first the equation. Hydrogen and iodine. Hydrogen plus iodine gives 2HA. This is they are giving. The moles of hydrogen is given as 15 moles and the iodine is 5.2. And then what they are at equilibrium, number of moles of HA is found to be 10 mole. So initially it is 0 at equilibrium. Let me write the data. At equilibrium you are getting 10 moles of it. And then they ask you to find out the what is called as the equilibrium constant. This is the question. Now let us see your thing is here. Knowledge is 2x is equal to 10. X is equal to 10 by 2 is equal to 5. So how you can write is hydrogen plus iodine gives 2HI. 2x is equal to 10. Here how we are getting this is 15 minus x, that is 15 minus 5, that what you are getting is 10. This is at equilibrium. Here initially you are having 5.2. 5.2 minus of 5, what you are getting is 0.2 at equilibrium. Here 2x which is it is having the at equilibrium. So now what is the formula for this is called as a K equilibrium is equal to product, that is HI to the stoichiometric divided by hydrogen. This is the formula of course. Now let us go on substitution. Here it is 10. So now 10 square divided by 10 into 0.2. Now let me write here 10 into 10 divided by 10 into 0.2. This is the getting cancer. And this is you bring it here. So both are multiplied by 10. So what I am getting is 100 divided by what is called 20. Okay, 100. Here to bring remove this one. Divide, multiply both by 10. So there you are having 100. Here divide by 2. 100 by 2. So your answer is 50. Let us go and see the option. The A is you are having the 50. Here what is the important knowledge is, here it is called as a 2x is equal to, this is as a 2x is the terminal, from that you find out the x and that should be subtracted here and substitute in the equation, you can get the answer. Thank you children.